tregu i barnave gjenerike në Shtetet e Bashkuara të Amerikës vetëm gjatë vitit 2018 ka arritur vlerën e 103 miliard dollarëve. Në SBA, barnat gjenerike kanë shënuar ngritje substanciale në prodhimin e tyre, pasi ato janë më pak të kushtueshme se sa barnat e brenduara dhe nuk kërkojnë hulumtime të gjëra dhe testimin e tyre. Në SBA ka pasur ngritje të aprovimeve të përdorimit të barnave gjenerike, sipas hulumtimeve të bëra gjatë vitit 2019, pritet që vlera në tregun amerikan lidhur me këto barna të arrijë në mbi 190 miliard dollar, me një rritje prej 10% çdo vit deri në vitin 2024. Në një treg prej qindra miliarda dollarve, rriten mundësit dhe kërkesat për mashtrime endemike të kompanive të ndryshme që selin e kanë jo vetëm në SBA, por edhe Indi dhe Kinë. Këto mashtrime janë shpjeguar në librin Bottle of Lies, Shishja e Mashtrimeve, të autorës Catherine Eben. Deri të zbulimi dhe ekspozimi këtyre mashtrimeve, erdhi si rezultati bashkëdyzimit dhe bashkëpunimit në mes të gazetarës hulumtuese Catherine Eben dhe sinjalizuesit Dinesh Tucker.
So he began to investigate, and he discovered that Ranbaxy had lied to regulators in more than 40 countries around the world, that 200 of its drug products were made with completely false data. But really, it's a tale of heroism, because instead of just walking away from the situation and concluding that it was not his problem anymore, he could not sleep at night. So he did something really incredible for an Indian executive, which is that he, because whistleblowers in India are very threatened. They don't last long. But instead, he wrote to regulators around the world. He wrote to regulators in the European Union, in Brazil, the World Health Organization, the FDA in the US, and basically told them that there was this fraud taking place. And really, not a single person got back to him, and it was the tip of the iceberg. And I follow an FDA investigator named Peter Baker, who went into 86 plants in India and China over a 5-year period and discovered fraud in 4/5 of those plants. So the book is being very widely read and debated. Patients have been very grateful because they want this information, they want to know. Also, I think some patients have had experiences where their drugs don't work, they don't know why, and they want answers. I've also been in touch with members of Congress and their offices, so they are looking into this. And I think there is a question now about how much will change as a result of this.